Next is gentleman from New Hampshire, Mr. Bass.
Thank you very much, Mr. Chairman. It is indeed a unique pleasure to see you chairing this distinguished committee here today. You should be proud of that. I had the honor of serving on this committee for 8 years, and I joined the committee at the time that Congressman, now Governor of Ohio, John Kasich assumed the chairmanship of the committee, and the nation at that time faced many of the same opportunities that we face here today. That was 1995. We were faced with what we consider to be chronically institutional deficits that didn't appear to be endless. And under the leadership of John Kasich and our leadership in the House and Senate at that time, we were able to send President Clinton budgets that brought us not only into balance but into surplus within 4 years. We have the same opportunity today, although the challenges are much greater. But I think this committee can make these difficult choices. But within that context, I have a couple of recommendations. Number one, I believe that every single dollar that is expended by this government should be subject to scrutiny and should be on the table. That includes all entitlements, it includes defense, and includes non-defense discretionary spending. There is no item or line item in the federal government that should not be subject to budgetary oversight and scrutiny. Secondly, I recommend to you, having been through 8 budget cycles on this committee, that the simpler the budget is, the more likely it is to be able, A, to pass, and B, to be implementable through reconciliation by the committees that have jurisdiction over the entitlement side of spending. I know that the committee will be discussing all sorts of different recommendations that will be provided by research and by staff and by the CBO and by other interest groups. But to the extent that you can give the authorizing committees, and the major ones, of course, are Ways and Means and Energy and Commerce, the ability to do as much as they can and be as innovative as they can with the minimum amount of direction, if you will, from the budget committee, I think that it's more likely, A, that we'll pass the budget, and B, that the committees will be able to do their work. To the extent that you do provide recommendations, watch out for downshifting. One program in particular comes to mind, which I fought hard for when I was on this committee, and that's full funding of special education, otherwise known as IDEA funding. Because we set the rules here in Washington but provide an unfortunately small percentage of the funding, states and localities have to come up with the funding to meet the goals of the law. So if we decide to cut IDEA funding, we're going to be shifting on a dollar-for-dollar basis that additional cost to cities and to states. And you, Mr. Chairman, would know as well as anybody, because of the years of distinguished service that you gave New Hampshire's largest city as its mayor. Fourthly, I'm glad that the committee is bringing up the budget sooner rather than later and sticking with the statutory schedule that was outlined in the Budget Empowerment and Control Act of 1974. We are now embroiled in a controversy over last year's budget, which was not a controversy that we wanted to have, but we inherited it from the previous administration. Don't allow us to get tied up in that so that we wind up where the previous leadership was last year, with no budget, no appropriations, no reconciliation. That would be that would define failure. I'm glad that we're bringing the budget out, and we're bringing it out soon, and that we can move forward with FY12 funding as quickly as possible. As I said in the beginning of my testimony, this is a unique opportunity, once again, to turn the direction of America away from runaway spending and toward getting our spending under control and moving toward a goal of living within our means. However, at some point, I think the Budget Committee and the Rules Committee should have some serious and detailed hearings on the issue of budget process reform and get testimony from people like myself and others who have ideas as to how this system can work better than it does today. I myself have discussed for some time the reestablishment of a committee that was established back in the early 40s called the Non-Essential Federal Expenditure, or Reduction in Non-Essential Federal Expenditures Committee, established by Harry F. Byrd in the early 40s. It is credited with the fact that most of the Depression-era make-work programs that were enacted by the Congress in the 30s are no longer in existence today. The committee should look at mechanisms that create incentives for members of Congress to want to vote to reduce spending rather than to increase spending. And one way to do that is to give either this committee or a permanent select committee the ability to bring spending reduction proposals from any portion of the budget directly to the floor of the House in the form of a resolution for a vote. And then let the general public decide whether they think this is a good idea or not. So, having said these things, Mr. Chairman, I believe that this committee has enormous challenges over the next month or two, but also enormous opportunities. You will be cutting new ground, as occurred back in 1995. Don't let it pass. I know it won't. I know that the members of this committee are dedicated to fiscal responsibility, to low taxes, and to a government that will promote job creation and economic recovery. And with that, I thank you for your time and wish you well.
Well, I thank you, sir, for coming and testifying and sharing the challenges and opportunities that this nation faced back in the mid-90s. And I thank you for your service in bringing fiscal responsibility and discipline again to our nation. And I, too, feel that while the challenges remain some of the greatest that we've ever faced, I too am optimistic that we are up for the challenge. And
thank you.
Difficult decisions have to be made, but I look forward to continuing our work on behalf of New Hampshire and the nation. I've appreciated your counsel and the responsibility that you've assumed in this 112th Congress, and look forward to many more moments of dialogue with you, and hopefully that we can implement some of the things that you've talked about here today. Thank you
very
sir.
Much, Mr. Chairman.